Welcome to Cell Clips. In this video, we will be discussing endocytosis, the process of bringing large molecules into the cell. Endocytosis provides the cell with a way to ingest macronutrients, such as iron and lipids, and to regulate cell signaling. While there are many types of endocytosis, in this video we will be focusing primarily on receptor-mediated or clatherin-mediated endocytosis. There are four major steps in receptor-mediated endocytosis. First, vesicle formation. Second, sorting. Third, maturation. And fourth, lysosomal fusion. Let's walk through each of these steps, starting with vesicle formation. Endocytic vesicles form in areas of the plasma membrane where cell surface receptors are found. In some cases, vesicles will only form when receptors are bound by a ligand. This is called stimulated endocytosis. In other cases, receptors are continually internalized whether or not they are bound by a ligand. This is called constitutive endocytosis. In either case, the vesicle formation begins when the phospholipid in the membrane, called PIP2, is bound by an adapter protein called AP2. Binding PIP2 causes conformational changes in AP2, which allows it to bind receptors in the membrane and recruit a coat protein called clatherin. As we described in our Cell Clips video on vesicle budding, the coat proteins COP1 and COP2 form complexes that naturally take the shape of a sphere. Clatherin works in the same way. So as several clatherin proteins bind AP2, the membrane starts to curve in toward the cytosol to form a budding vesicle. Complete vesicle fusion requires a large GTPase called dynamin. Dynamin forms helical strands that wrap around the thin neck of the budding vesicle. As it hydrolyzes GTP, the spiral constricts, causing the vesicle to pinch off from the membrane. This leads us into the second step of endocytosis, sorting. There are two main destinations for endocytosed material. They can be recycled to the cell surface, or they can be degraded in the lysosome. All incoming vesicles first fuse with an early endosome, where their cargo is sorted into one of these pathways. Endosomes contain proton pumps, so they are slightly acidic. When a vesicle fuses with an early endosome, the lower pH causes the receptors to release their ligands into the endosome lumen. All ligands and some receptors remain in the endosome to be degraded. Receptors to be recycled are packaged into new vesicles that return to the plasma membrane. The early endosome containing the ligands and any remaining receptors will now mature into a late endosome to prepare for degradation in the lysosome. Endosome maturation itself is a multi-step process. The first transition is the formation of multivesicular bodies. While the ligands were released into the endosome lumen, receptors and other proteins remain in the endosome membrane. This presents a problem, as the membrane protects regions of these proteins from degradation enzymes. To overcome this problem, regions of the endosome membrane containing membrane proteins curve in toward the lumen and bud off, forming luminal vesicles. Endosomes with these luminal vesicles are called multivesicular bodies. Now, all the endosome cargo is contained within the lumen and is accessible to proteolytic enzymes. The next step in endosome maturation is glycosylation. Because hydrolytic lysosome enzymes are capable of degrading both proteins and lipids, even the endosome membrane is at risk of damage, but it is critical that the endosome membrane remain intact to protect the rest of the cell from exposure to these degrading enzymes. Therefore, the luminal side of the endosome must be protected. This is accomplished through glycosylation. Transferase enzymes in the endosome covalently attach carbohydrates to proteins in the endosome membrane, creating a thick, protective layer called a glycocalyx, which cannot be degraded by lysosome enzymes. The final maturation step is acidification. As mentioned earlier, endosomes contain proton pumps that continually use energy to bring protons into the endosome. Therefore, throughout endosome maturation, the pH is steadily decreasing, making late endosomes very acidic. Once these changes have occurred, the late endosome is now prepared to fuse with the lysosome. Lysosomes are formed by enzyme-containing vesicles from the transgolgi. They are highly acidic, and their hydrolytic enzymes operate optimally under these conditions. After fusion, these enzymes degrade proteins, DNA, RNA, and lipids into small components such as individual amino acids, nucleotides, and fatty acids. These components are then transported into the cytosol, where they are repurposed by the cell. Since everything from the endosome is degraded, what remains is just a lysosome, which then can fuse with another late endosome to repeat this process. So in summary, endocytosis is a process used to bring large molecules into the cell. Receptors and their ligands are often internalized through clatherin-coated vesicles that fuse with early endosomes. Recycled receptors are packaged into vesicles that eventually fuse with the cell membrane, returning them to the cell surface. Ligands and receptors to be degraded remain in the early endosome, which matures into the late endosome with the formation of multivesicular bodies, glycosylation, and acidification. Late endosomes then fuse with lysosomes full of enzymes that degrade everything inside the endosome. Well, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching Cell Clips.